thanks for stopping by and visiting our booth. We're really interested in knowing, you know, what you think about our antennas, our technologies, and you know, what you've used from our products.
Thank you. So Bluespan Wireless decided we wanted to try the carrier class antennas. We'd previously been using some of the Ubiquiti and some other manufacturers out there, and we were concerned about getting a performance increase. So we took a look at your carrier class antenna, and what we did is we put them in the same environment. What we saw was a marked improvement, especially with some of our clients that were on the fringes, with those sectors being a 100 degree sector. We found that we cleaned that up a little bit. We've got some great shots. Even at 10 miles, the antenna is performing beautifully. So we're very pleased.
What kind of radios are you using?
And so right now we use a mix of different things, but mostly Microtech radios in the field. We're using the net metals on the carrier class antennas right now.
And what did you feel as far as the install, the physical use of the antenna compared to traditional antennas that you were using previously?
Easier. It's just not a huge difference. I mean, it's still kind of the same footprint, but the antenna went in with ease. The beauty of it is that, you know, before we would have to put armor on those antennas.
Right, yeah.
Today, we can deploy this in a half the time period because we're not constructing armor to go around it. So from that standpoint alone, it was a no-brainer for our company to deploy this antenna over all the other ones that don't have, you know, basically shielding built into it. The shielding built into this was really a game changer for us.
Yeah, so how much, how would you say the necessity for the shielding that you're putting up, and how is it affecting the wind loading on your towers and stuff? I mean, it's
not at all. In fact, the wind loading on our tower is negligible because we didn't have a lot of problems with it to begin with, but with the RF armor, the wind load is much higher because it's creating this sail around the sector, whereas with this sector we don't have that. So it's significantly less from that angle.
Cool. And then as far as the client connections, I mean, how are you seeing the beam and the chain-to-chain performance versus other?
I would say right now we probably saw around a 15 to 20% increase overall in quality of signals.
Better match, yeah.
Yeah. So which to us was a huge market improvement because, you know, when you're dealing with signals that, you know, might be on the fringe, it allows you to put that many more customers on service that ordinarily you would turn down.
Yeah. Are you seeing an increase in performance as to the number of clients per AP with our sector versus other sectors?
Yes, absolutely. I would say, again, we've probably seen a 15-20% increase.
Excellent. Great. Tell us a little bit more about your company as far as where you're located and you know, how many subs you have.
Sure. So we're my name is Scott, of course, and I'm with Bluespan Wireless. We're a company that provides service to from about 25 miles north of Tucson all the way to the U.S.-Mexican border. So we got a pretty large footprint. Our area, our territory, encompasses a service footprint of a little over 1 million people.
Wow.
So it's a big market. Our growth rate is probably about 500. I think last year we had a 540% growth rate.
Excellent.
So we're jamming. So for us, everything counts. When you say, oh, I only got a 20% increase, well, a 20% increase to us is huge when you're talking in those numbers. So having, you know, well over 1,000 subs just to start with, and then moving up hundreds of them a month, it's very important we have the right antennas, the right products, the right equipment in the field, and it just has to work.
Right.
You know, to put an unproven technology out there is far worse for us because of the speed we're moving and the growth rate that we're experiencing. But we're very pleased with the selection of these antennas.
Great. If you were to be able to kind of sum it up in a phase or, you know, in a couple of words, I mean, what would you say to describe RF Elements as a company and our products?
So if I had to put a phrase together, the one thing I like about you guys is you do exactly what you say you're going to do. You know, in our industry, the biggest problem we've had is a company will promise the sun, the moon, the stars, and then they just don't deliver. You know, a lot of marketing hype, what I call all of the sizzle, none of the steak.
Right.
You guys...
We like steak.
Yeah, you like steak. The bottom line was, is we looked at this product, it did exactly what you said it would do. And when we called to talk to people about it, we got to speak with experienced people who actually were concerned about making sure we got what we needed. and got the support we needed to put the product in properly. And that goes a long way in our business.
Great, excellent. Well, hey, we appreciate your support. Thanks
for
talking to us.
You bet.
Thanks.